Hi everyone, Tempthany Rise Tano here, the internet's busiest music nerd, and it is time for a review of the new Boris album, No. This is the newest full-length LP from Japanese metal, rock, and drone outfit Boris. With almost three decades as a band under their belts, Takashi, Atsuo, and Wata are back, and after all this time they are as prolific as ever, to the point where even I have a hard time keeping up with all of it. I think the last time I reviewed their music was back in 2017 with the album Dear, which was a good record, but they've dropped at least a few other projects since then. Given the incredible diversity of albums that Boris has released over the years, with a new project, you never really know what you're gonna get into. Will it be a total riff fest, something more noisy and abstract, shoegaze or dream pop? No happens to be one of their more high-octane thrillers, so fans of previous records like Pink or even Heavy Rocks might want to take notice here. But do not assume No is just some kind of sludgy, doomy return to form for Boris. It's certainly not that, as the band embarks on a series of fiery, relentless ragers that dabble in crust punk, Japanese hardcore, as well as crossover thrash. The band's sludge metal influences, of course, are not entirely out of the picture. Regardless of the speed and aggression the band is delivering throughout these tracks, the guitar tones are still heavy and chunky as hell. Plus, there's also the intro track, Genesis, which is a 6-minute instrumental cut with lots of slow, doomy riffs, tons of atmosphere and thunderous drums and wailing, colorful guitar leads. The pace picks up nicely in the last leg with the final minute of the song getting really layered and reverby and thick. In concept, it doesn't really make too much sense to incorporate a track like this onto an album of punk-inspired tunes, but it still sounds good, and I guess it is a quality tone setter for the record in that it is very ominous. We also have the very slow and heavy Zerkalo, the fifth track on the record, which is maybe a mid-album slowdown. The twisted riffs on this track, the absolutely ghoulish and freakish lead vocals and screams, along with all the feedback, make this one of the nastiest listens on the entire LP, even if it is one of the slower ones as well. So again, all of the tracks on this LP are not a total departure from Boris's typical sound, but what is most important is when a slower track is worked into this thing, it doesn't ruin the record, it doesn't take away from the aggression of the more punk-inspired tracks, it doesn't derail the momentum. I would say the closest this album comes to doing that is the final track, which is just titled Interlude, so the record finishes off with a 3-minute interlude, which is sort of a dreamy ambient number with lots of reversed guitars and whispered vocals and cavernous reverb. The rest of the record, though, absolutely rips, my god. The track Antigone, with its speedy metal and punk fusion riffs, killer drumming, ferocious lead vocals. The band has never sounded so visceral and furious, and the sound of this track and many others is just incredible. I love the way the band has effectively balanced speed with that heaviness, but also the muscular tone and detail that you would need to basically tell what is going on with everything going so fast. So that thickness and also that definition is very much appreciated. However, that's not always a focus on the album. For example, the track Temple of Hatred, which goes so fast it essentially becomes this dizzying whirlwind of sludgy noise rock, popping in occasionally with the skate punk whoa vocals. The Perforation Line song in the middle of the tracklist is a strange centerpiece for No. Not exactly sure what the band is trying to signify with this placement and this title, but it's still a highlight for me. What Boris has actually done sonically and musically on this track, I think, is a little ingenious. I actually wish more songs dabbled in something of this nature, because this track kind of sounds like a cross between hardcore punk and super dreamy, blissful shoegaze. In a way, the track is kind of at odds with itself, as the very fast drums don't really sync up all that tightly with the very, very bright and colorful wall of sound that they are attached to, which also doesn't play exactly to the screamed punk vocals that are peppered throughout the track as well. But the song is somehow still really gratifying, especially as the whole thing devolves into a dissonant and distorted wall of sound at the end, reminding me somewhat of like an old No Age song or even a Black Gaze track. So the ass kickers in this track list continue, whether it be Kiki no Yue or the blistering and claustrophobic classic Fundamental Terror. The only shorter tracks that really left me somewhat underwhelmed were Lust, which is a thrashy instrumental with a monstrous sound, but without some strong vocals and a song to weave it all together, the riffs come off somewhat forgettable and generic, though some of the weird background noises and sound effects that are peppered throughout the track are something, certainly. There's also Non-Blood Lore, which, don't get me wrong, there are many aspects of this track I find fantastic, but the vocal harmonies that pop up on the hook are so sloppily performed and layered and mixed, it's a bit of an ear sore. The song Loveless is pretty much the record's final song of consequence. Every strain of musical aggression the band has been dealing in so far culminates onto this one track, which is stretched out into a 6-minute multi-phased barn burner. There is a mid-paced and mosh-friendly intro with kind of whacked out and super basic guitar leads. It really does sound like a heavier version of some basic, straightforward, punked out 80s crossover shit. Then the band suddenly breaks into these very classic, thrashy, speedy riffs, throat-shredding vocals, what sounds like tambourine as well, keeping pace with the snare of the song. Can't say I've heard too much tamb over the years in my thrash. Just a relentless performance until the band hits some really doomy riffs on the back end, which introduces a very atmospheric outro. These vocal harmonies that sound like a religious crossover thrash metal, stoner metal chant. For sure, it's an epic ending and speaks to Boris's incredible versatility. Basically, this record, I loved it. It rules. It is not the most novel idea in the world, and sure, there are a handful of songs that I think could have been better, but damn, this thing goes hard, and it is the most kick-ass Boris has sounded in a long time. I'm feeling a decent 2 strong 8 on this one. Transition, have you given this album a listen? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What would you rate it? You're the best, you're the best. What should I review next? Hit the like if you like. Please subscribe, and please don't cry. Hit the bell as well. Over here next to my head is another video that you can check out. Hit that upworthy link to subscribe to the channel. Anthony Fantano, Boris, no, forever.